And so, trending topic strikes again. Let's hit it. How's it going, fellow YouTubers, content creators, lurkers of the internet? My name is Ilya and welcome to the weekly Wednesday vlog. It is absolutely no secret what has been the most popular and controversial topic in the news these days concerning social media news. K-pop! And unlike most people, I'm not here to share an opinion because nobody cares. Not only because I'm a small YouTuber, but just because nobody cares.
K-pop, right guys?
But I do want to sum up the opinions of some of the bigger YouTubers out there into one little compact package which you can enjoy, or not enjoy, or hate, whatever, it's up to you. And of course we're talking about YouTube Rewind 2018, which is the most disliked video in the history of YouTube ever.
How bad can it really be? Come on, why is everyone complaining about this year's Rewind?
It has, let me check how much. It has 13 million dislikes and it's not gonna stop anytime soon. It starts off with Will Smith, but he hasn't said anything on the topic yet, at least not publicly as far as I know. So let's start with MKBHD. Or as Will Smith would say,
and Marquez Brownlee.
Marquez made a long, super concise and interesting to watch video on the topic, but just to summarize that in one sentence, he pretty much said, YouTube doesn't really know its community and what it wants, or maybe it's intentionally trying to separate itself away from its community. So pretty much that video wasn't targeting the community and trying to satisfy all the people who are watching YouTube, but rather the advertisers who are looking at the platform to invest into.
So YouTube Rewind, in a way, just turned into a giant ad for YouTube.
So that video was obviously not anything close to what the viewers wanted to see. And he generally mentioned that it was just too much of everything, too many things going on, too many important things that were just like cut off in a couple seconds and you couldn't get the whole story and what's going on there. It's just too confusing.
And they just try to shove everything into this video every year. And I think that's the mistake.
Dan TDM pointed out that over the years, YouTube has been throwing out this Rewind every time and was really awesome. So people had really high expectations. And when you have super high expectations from different kinds of audiences, it's very difficult to make something that's gonna perform well and satisfy everyone.
YouTube Rewind, creating that has to be one of the hardest jobs and one of the hardest videos to make of the whole year on YouTube. Out of every video that's uploaded, that has to be one of the hardest ones. And to get all of those trends into one 8-minute video is a pretty tough ask.
Pretty much making a wow video is very, very difficult. To expand on that, Philip DeFranco said that probably it's not even possible for YouTube to make a video that's gonna satisfy everyone.
But at the same time, I don't know if YouTube could actually make anything that would be widely well received.
First of all, you have the community versus the advertisers, which are two very separate types of audiences and they want to see different things. Plus within the YouTube community, there are so many groups and people taking sides or liking one fan that's like an enemy of another fan, that you put out a video and it's absolutely guaranteed that someone's gonna love it and someone's gonna hate it, and it's impossible to just make a successful video across the board. Evan Edinger pretty much mentioned all that and also took a walk through the history of YouTube Rewind, which was very interesting to watch, and I definitely suggest you should watch it. It's note here.
But in order to really understand why 2018 YouTube Rewind was so bad, we gotta rewind a bit. Let's see what happened in the past. Why was the past good, or was it really?
H3H3 Productions just said, it's time to stop.
It's time to stop YouTube Rewind.
He pointed out that almost every role in the video was completely fake and didn't match the character playing it at all.
Why is Casey Mr. K-pop? How did he end up as Mr. K-pop? Casey, what's going on here?
And on the other hand, there are so many epic channels and amazing content and viral videos that were out this year that weren't touched on at all in this video.
Do you know who really needs to be in this YouTube Rewind video? Shane Dawson, who had one of the most explosive years on YouTube ever. How about PewDiePie? How about KSI versus Logan Paul? How about Mr. Beast's meteoric rise?
Now, Casey was kind of on the opposite side of the scale. He was defending the production team, and he does have some very serious good points on that matter.
You know, their intention was to make something that felt inclusive. Their intention was to make something that maybe talked about the more altruistic aspects of this platform that often get overlooked.
But his main argument was that it was the intention of the production team to do one thing, but then if your intention doesn't generate the expected results, then what's the point of the intention in the first place?
Advertisers keep showing up here on YouTube because it's what enables so much of us to do what we do.
But that's not right either. It's the community, the viewers, who make the creators be able to create. And then PewDiePie. Well, PewDiePie just did what PewDiePie always does, watched the video and made fun of it.
Well, you clearly messed up, didn't you? This is why you don't leave it up to the YouTubers.
But he was right, it's cringy at best.
Sorry.
And according to The Verge, a YouTube representative said that dethroning Baby in dislikes wasn't exactly our goal. No sh**. And congratulations, Justin Bieber, you're no longer the most disliked author or personality on YouTube. And I'm just gonna add my own note to the end of this video. Amazing thinkers and speakers like Kareem Rashid and Gary Vee, they all point out that we're entering into a new era. An era of honesty, an era of transparency where people want to see the reality of things because people are tired of seeing the mask of people faking their lifestyle and what they're all about. And for me, watching this whole video, the number one description of this video is fake. And that kind of things just don't go through anymore, at least that's how I see it. And me being a minimalist, I really believe that less is more. So many things jumbled up together, so much of everything, you just don't get anything. You don't get the message, you don't get the art, you don't get the production, it was just a bleh. And like they say, trends and fashions go around in circles, so now that we're over with all this too much of everything and colorful and all those edits and gaming things, I think we're coming back to something simple. So I wouldn't be surprised if next year someone sitting in front of a white background and just telling their story is gonna be like a super viral video. I guess we'll see. So tell me in the comments below what you guys thought about the latest YouTube Rewind video 2018. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, I'm gonna see you guys next week. I could go back to doing ultra wide. Check this out. I just wanna go on. That is so wide.